is the 62-year-old Scottish musician still has plenty to sing about. A singer's voice changes over time, but for any man next, this isn't true of just pitch or tone. For her, change has occurred at the deepest levels of circumstance, style, and heart. Career. Though Nanmax studied at Royal Academy of Music in London, her work has been far from classical. Her band, The Tourist, found some success in Europe, but the group separated in November of 1980. However, by December, Nanmax had formed a duo called Eurythmics with band member Dave Stewart. Nanmax and Stewart were launched to fame before breaking up and embarking to successful careers as a solo artist and a music producer. Along with her career. She musical contribution has also changed throughout the year. Punk and pop music were a significant part of Eurythmics' years. Once she began to record on her own, she seems interested in doing more soul and jazz. Her most recent and perhaps final album,
Nostalgia,
is composed of jazz standards. Cause and in the next career took another turn when she accepted an invitation from Nelson Mandela to visit South Africa in 2003. She was a guest of 46664, Mandela's HIV AIDS Foundation, and saw the ugly reality of the disease. Since that time, Nanmax has worked to raise awareness, especially regarding the high number of female victims. This is not about a medical issue, it's about human rights, gender and social justice, and behavioral practice, she said. Communication. Though many see her as a
celebrity,
Nanmax doesn't feel she fit in with the crowd. What I am is a musician and a communicator, she offers instead. I want to make something that touches people and makes them feel something. There are times when Nanmax feel that her voice, whether in songs or speech, create little effect. But I continue to draw strength and inspiration from courageous people whom I have met who live with HIV. It seems that Nanmax will continue singing, not so much for fans as for her work.
How?